has been very powerful and mind-opening for me. And so I'm so excited to introduce you to our next speaker, Robin Dixon from Hospice Santa Cruz County. Let's give it up for Robin.
Talk to us from across the room from the spot on the couch. She would read a book there, curl her hair there. I'd fallen asleep in the same spot. I remember the sun coming down on me. It was warm and I'd just woken up. I was still in that hazy place. And the question that had been on my mind for 10 days now came back to me. What am I going to do now? I sat there for a while in that space and I looked up and I saw my dad walking toward me. And as he walked toward me, he came and he sat in the gold chair right beside me, put his hands in his lap. And I looked at him, and after a while, we sat there quietly in a nice, sweet space. And I said, "Dad, I think I have to go home." And he looked at me without skipping a beat. And he said, "Of course you do." I learned that day that even when we don't see ourselves, the people who love us can see us. I came back to Santa Cruz, which was hard. If anyone's ever experienced a loss like this, coming back to your life is the hardest part. You feel like you were on a track before, but suddenly you're not on a track at all. I couldn't make plans in quite the same way that I had before. The lists that I used to make didn't make as much sense as they used to. So I had a choice. I thought I could either spend my time putting things together in the way they used to be, scrambling to make sense in the way that things used to make sense. Or I could embrace it. I could decide I was lost. I was going to be lost for a while. And I didn't know what that was going to look like, but I could find out. So that's what I did. And what I found out was that being lost is not that bad. I was more present in a way that I'd never been present in my life. I didn't need the list in the way I needed the list before. I didn't need the drive. I didn't need to know how. I could just. Eventually, someone suggested that I go to a grief group at Hospice of Santa Cruz County. At first, I thought they were just tired of listening to me. I decided to go anyway. And about 5 weeks into that group, I remember there was a man, everyone had lost a parent, there was a man sitting beside me who had become a friend at that point. And he said, "I just need to get back to where I was. I can't do this anymore. I have to get back to where I was. I need my life on track." And we all sat there quietly thinking the exact thing, I'm sure. And eventually I said, "I don't think we get to go back, but I do think the next step is good too." It was the first positive thing I'd said in 6 months, and I realized I'd turned a corner. The reason I'm telling all of you this is because we will all have losses. We'll lose parents, we'll lose relationships, we'll lose dreams. But what I hope for all of you in all of that is that you will turn toward yourself. Let yourself be lost. Embrace the unknown. Because as a nurse once told me, we die how we live.
Thank you, Robin. Wow. And we get to look at this chair, too. Wow, thank you. I always learn something when I'm with you. Thank